blue and glowing, appeared around her in a semicircle and looked at her. And they were waiting for her to say something else, but she was so flabbergasted by actually seeing these beings, she just stood there and looked at them, and after a few minutes they disappeared.
I would like to tell you at this point that I've been talking with some 10 to 15 foot tall blue beings for several years now, and they're telling me to bring in a form of energy medicine, which I've been teaching, so I think I know who these guys are. I think they're
They are
curious.
A very active group in our world. Very active.
I know.
There's a form of, a very esoteric form of meditation that comes from the Wudang Mountain region of Tibet that was given to humans by a set of beings that fit that same description, 10 to 15 feet tall. And in this type of meditation, it's a rapid form of enlightenment where your kundalini is activated in a very controlled and pleasant, healthy manner, and the energy that is around you opens up in such a way that your physical body begins to transform into energy. And the whole process takes anywhere from 2 months to 2 years, depending on which part of the process you focus on. But it was also given to us by these same tall blue beings. When I looked at Dejante, he was 8 to 10 feet tall and blue. So there seems to be some connection with humans and these tall blue beings.
Yeah, they've given me a name for this group. They're part of the healing core of the Ashtar Command from Sirius B, and they tell me their name is the Ankanash, which comes from three letters in the Kabbalah, meaning I, palm of hand, and flame. So,
yeah.
I think they're a subset of a larger group.
I do too. In a book I just read on Taoism, they say that many of the teachings that relate to enlightenment and spiritual growth in our world are given to us by beings who are from other galaxies or other star systems that come into our world and appear as spiritual beings, but in reality, they're beings just like us who have grown and evolved beyond the need for a physical form. So
right.
A lot of us are having the same sort of consciousness experience with these beings.
I can't tell you how excited I am to talk to you because you're giving me information I need. And
good.
I don't know anybody else who knows it.
But there are a lot of people that know it, but the media as it is now is really almost flooded with information related to the secret, and that's not denigrating the secret, but there's a depth of knowledge and information that's necessary for human evolution of consciousness that we just don't get. And when you try to put it on the radio or on TV, you find that people say, well, it's too out there, people aren't ready for it. And I think the absolute opposite is true. I think people are hungry for it. I think that they're more than ready for it. And I think that in time, this will become, the evolution will become the norm. We won't focus just on trying to heal or be healthy. We'll be focusing on transformation of the physical body into something much greater than what we see now. I think that's the next step in our evolution and growth.